Our first guest on the program today, Kerry Pasch, is author of Your Story for His Glory. Welcome to the program.
Hi, thank you so much for having me today. It's really a pleasure being here.
Yeah, well, it's great to have you on with us. And you recently took a leap of faith to write this new book. Share with us a little bit about what led you to writing the book.
Sure, absolutely. So each day, it's really important for me to carve aside time to be with God, especially in the morning. I like to take time to read the Bible and then write in my journal, either reflecting on scriptures that hit me or previous life experience where God's just really impacted my life. And one day, I decided to share some of my writings with my husband. And when I did that, he turned to me and said, "Kerry, you really need to consider publishing these writings and making a book because I really think they can help people." And I remember saying to him, "You've got to be out of your mind. Like, that's the craziest thing. And what makes you think that someone's going to be interested in my journal?" And I walked away just laughing at the idea, deleting it from my brain. But the more and more that I thought about it, the more it kept resurfacing and I couldn't resist the idea. And it occurred to me that God was really using my husband to plant that seed in my heart to share my writings and publish my book. And, you know, I struggled and I wrestled with that whole idea because it would require me to put myself out there and my faith out there in a really big way. And I mulled over the questions of what would people say and what would they think. But eventually I realized that it's not about me. You know, it's about God, and I need to put my fears and my insecurities aside, because if my writings could help bring just one person closer in relationship to God, then that would be worth all my time and energy. So that's exactly what I did.
Well, that is awesome. And as you wrote the book, what are you hoping that people that read it get out of what you've put down for them?
Sure. My hope and prayer, like I said, for the book is to help connect, you know, any one person to just grow in their relationship with God, wherever that is, whatever season they are in life. You know, I really just put that prayer over my book to engage with people in any way. And my book really is divided into chapters of different stories and experiences. So you can really get a good sense of, you know, my faith journey with God. And I just hope it connects with people and brings them closer to the Lord.
Okay. And I want to ask, a lot of us are facing different changes in our lives. I think everybody has been affected some way because of this COVID pandemic, and a lot of people are looking for encouragement through that. But share with us about how your life has been through this whole COVID pandemic.
Sure. So like you said, Tom, I think that COVID has affected so many people and on so many different levels. For me personally, it's affected my career and my business. My husband and I, we own our own company. And prior to COVID, we were traveling all the time. Business was great and plentiful. And then quarantine happened and all travel came to a screeching halt. And so did that area of our business. It dropped to zero really quickly. And my husband and I, we had to scramble and come up with new and innovative ways to remodel our company while we can serve our customers, but at the same time, be ahead of the curve in our industry. And it's all just been really challenging. But I think two things that we've really learned during this time is that perspective is so important, no matter what season of life you're in, because perspective can either limit or unlock opportunities that God is trying to work through you. And I think another important aspect we learned during this season was that even though there might be so many changes happening in the world around us, one thing that doesn't change is our steadfast faith in God. We know that no matter what situation is put in our way, God's going to deliver us from it. And even though these are really trying times for everyone across the world, I want to encourage people to seek the blessings in life, because they're happening every day and everywhere, every minute around us. You know, one of the most common and beautiful blessings I've heard about during this entire season is how people have been able to spend such quality time with their families. That's such a beautiful and wonderful aspect to me. And it's been true for me too. My husband and I, we've been married for 4 years, and I can honestly say this is the most time we've ever spent together. I really feel like God hit the pause button on our life and said, okay, enough with the crazy travel schedule. Now I want you to focus on you and your marriage and your relationships and your friendships. And that's just been such a gift in our life during this time. And I know it's so easy to get frustrated and to complain because there's so much negativity happening around us in the world. But I think it's really important for us to remind ourselves each day that we're still here. You know, we still have the breath of God in our lungs. And we need to wake up saying, what can I do to make today count? You know, what can I do to make the most of my life today in this moment? And I get it. You know, it's sometimes hard to see how we could possibly impact someone's life or how we could possibly be a blessing to somebody from the confinement of our home. But I want to remind you that COVID can't stop God's plan on your life. COVID can't stop God's church, and COVID can't stop God's people. It just can't. So we absolutely can have an impact on people's lives from the comfort of our home if we choose to. You see, it also reminds me of technology, which is such a funny thing because we often categorize technology as a distraction because many of the times it is for us in our life. But I think that technology, when used right, can be a really big blessing in our lives. For example, prior to COVID, one of the things I always wanted to do was start a Bible study group. It's just something I always wanted to do, but it was never possible with my travel schedule. And, you know, I couldn't commit the time to it. So the whole idea kind of just got shelved. But then quarantine happened. And in the beginning weeks of quarantine, God spoke to me and he said, Carrie, start now. Start that scripture study now. And I remember thinking to myself, how am I going to start a scripture study group when everyone's required to stay at home, let alone meet in small groups? It's just impossible. You see, my perspective was here. It was limited. And at the same time, this new app that people could connect virtually called Zoom was becoming the latest rage. And it was in that moment that I said, wow, I'm focused here and God's calling me here. You know, God's saying, I don't want you to focus locally. I want you to focus globally. And that's exactly what I did. I took my scripture study group online via Zoom. And do you know we had people signing up from all over the world, from Australia and Italy and all throughout the US and Canada. And it has been such a blessing to connect with each other every week, diving into God's word and just starting new relationships. In fact, I just finished my second scripture study group, and they're all recorded. You can see them on my website, carriepash.com. But just looking back, I love to reflect how this was a beautiful blessing that came out of such a chaotic period in our lives, something I would never expect.
Well, that is incredible, and thank you for sharing that with us, and encourage our viewers that want to connect with your Bible study. Again, the website's carriepash.com, and thank you for everything you're doing through the book and through just encouraging people today. And can I ask you to pray with all of our viewers today before we go?
Absolutely. So, dear Lord Jesus, I just want to pray for restoration and for healing over our nation and over the entire world, Lord. I pray specifically for every single person tuning in today, for peace in their heart, Lord, during these uncertain times, and to continue to have bold faith every day in you, despite our circumstances, Lord, knowing that your plans are higher and greater, and Lord, that you are the way, the truth, and the life, Lord. God, we give you praise in all that we do. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. And Carrie Pash is the author of Your Story for His Glory. Again, the website's carriepash.com. Thank you for sharing with us today. God bless you.
Thank you so much for having me.